If we were hanging out together, my question right now would be, who here has had a PCR test for COVID-19? And probably most of us have had a PCR test at one time or the other. So PCR takes advantage of the exact same stuff that we did for DNA sequencing, with one difference. PCR uses every, oops, oh, you can't see that. It uses every one of the ingredients. It uses the reverse transcriptase to make DNA. It uses DNA nucleotides, but PCR is one tube and normal nucleotides. But we're going to use TAC polymerase because we're going to heat this DNA up so that it denatures. TAC polymerase, then cool it down so that TAC polymerase can get in there and do some work, make copies, then heat it up again to denature the copies. In this way, we replicate the DNA. The key to the PCR test is the primer. So let's go. I'm going to PCR. We know how PCR works because we did it with the sequencing. So how does the PCR COVID test work? Well, we need special primers. And these primers are specific to COVID, to SARS-CoV-2. We needed the primers in the previous one, but we sort of had to guess to find the right primers in order to sequence the DNA, like the whole, or the, to sequence the nucleic acid. We were trying to figure it out. Here, we now know, because we sequenced SARS-CoV-2, we now know what the primers are. So, swab your nose, collect a sample. If there are viruses in there, if SARS-CoV-2 is in there, you swab the crap out of yourself. Remember when the very beginning when you had to swab like all the way up, and I remember just like my eyes would just water and water and water, and because that thing went so far up there. And then we didn't have to do that anymore because science is amazing and we learn. We adjust, we learn and adjust our practices, which is one of the most awesome things that happened with this wild pandemic. So we have the primers and you add the primers in. Now imagine, right now, I do not think I have COVID. So if I swabbed my nose and then we added the primers in, the primers bind to the COVID mRNA, not to any of mine. So I run it through PCR with TAC polymerase and adding all the nucleotides, like, go, guys, go, make copies. If there is no viral infection, then there's not going to be anything for the primer to bind to. So there's going to be no amplification of DNA. And you won't see it. Now, the interesting thing about the COVID PCR test is that they also add a fluorescent, they called it a fluorescent, what'd they call it? A fluorescent dye. They called it something else. I can't remember what they called it. A probe. A fluorescent probe, which is basically a dye. And it attaches to, if that primer attaches, then the probe also attaches. So basically, your replicated viral DNA will glow. The PCR test is read by how much glowing is happening. So if there's a lot of glowing, then you had a positive PCR test because there had to have been viral particles in that sample. If there's not a lot of glowing, then it's a negative PCR test. And because there, the viral DNA, there wasn't enough of it to be amplified. Does that make sense? How do you feel? That's how the PCR test works. And I don't know about you guys, but I guess there were some places locally where they could do a PCR test on site. So they had all the equipment. But a lot of our PCR tests got sent away. And you had to wait several days before you would get results because we didn't have, whoever took the test didn't have the equipment necessary to run all the PCR tests. Because it is an intensive process, a tech-heavy process. Which means it was inconvenient and expensive. So we developed another one that is not as expensive, and that is the antigen test. And I want to talk about how that works.